Hello friends, I'm Colonel Failure and this is Transport Fever. Last time around, we set up this Metroliner route that covers the delights of Port Nelson, Chicago and Toronto. And it's still bedding in at the moment. I think that train that just went past us has probably got a dozen passengers on board. But it will build up over time. And this is all designed, oriented towards increase. This is just a lovely shot. Soak it in. You know, admittedly, only once in a while a train goes past. But, you know, there's stuff happening in the background. And, you know, this is just a nicely framed shot. I hope you can appreciate that. What was I talking about? Port Nelson. Yes, Port Nelson. The aim is to get it to grow significantly over this side, which currently is not really doing anything. There's no one on board. No one wants to go anywhere. Oh no, some people want to go places. Anyway, this is all geared towards the introduction of food being produced and distributed. And once we've done so, exciting things are going to happen, and you're not going to want to miss out on exciting things. So stick around. We start out today at the Port Nelson docks, because this is the first thing that I'm going to set up. Not the docks that are already set up. Look at this, we've got two leaving at once, presumably with a full load. There we go, you're off to Edinburgh, and you are heading to Dublin. Magnificent. The reason we're starting here is because I'm going to up my amount of shipping, and I'm going to get that going immediately. You might question exactly what the heck I'm shipping. And how this relates to the introduction I made not so long ago. It will become clear, friends. Don't worry. Here we go. Right, so, you know what? Actually, the Toulouse line here, I ought to set that to auto-replace just since I'm passing. And that's running the Viola, I thought it was. Whatever it is, it's whatever it will take a multiple load of. There we go. That's it. Just shut up and get it going and move on. Right. Yes. Here we go. Line one. There. But I don't even know what that's for. Delete it. Right. Here we go. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4 more lines. 1, 2, 3, 4 more lines. And you know, the astute amongst you will have already spotted what my caper is here. But you know. Don't feel too embarrassed if you don't get it. We'll start with Toulouse, and we're going to go from Toulouse, thank you, all the way back to Port Nelson. Right? Yeah. Okay. That's one. And we're going to call this TOU food. Bulk. That's right. We're going to start shipping food out of the same port. And this, you know, it's going to take a long time to get anywhere, but it's going to be brilliant because it's going to just up the number of ships that we're running. So same deal with Dublin. Port Nelson. There we are. And the reason that... that I'm doing these first is because, as ever, we will be building these ships in Southampton. Now, this is an irrational thing to do. You know what? This would be faster if I just do that, right? Because, you know, docks themselves are actually, you know, very, very cheap to build. So I know the ability to create ships, very cheap. I could make them and then, concentrate. EDI, thank you. Food bulk. Yeah, you see, I've done it on the previous line. So it's not poor. I abbreviated port rather than abbreviating Dublin. You know, foolish. Food bulk. And then up here for Tromsø. Right, where are we? Here we go. There. Good. What was I talking about? Yeah, I've chosen... to build my ships in one city only, just because that's how I want to do it. And that means it's going to take a few years for these ships to do anything even slightly. But That's how I want to do it, and therefore that's how I'm going to do it. Right, 250 running costs, not cheap, but that's fine. Right, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. There, a nice investment there. Right, you get working on. You can be Dublin. There you are. Off you go. Set sail, my friend. Your turn next. That one. Thank you. You can go to Edinburgh. Off you trot. This one can head out to somewhere else. Toulouse? No. Toulouse. Yes. Now, I want to also add additional destinations for these chaps at some... additional destinations from Port Nelson. And the hope is that eventually Port Nelson is so busy I have to run, you know, multiple ports there. And to be honest, this might be enough to qualify for that now. But we'll see. There you go. Massive container ships, all of them heading around the world, coming out of Southampton. Thing of beauty. Now, in order to make those work, this is more effort than I was intending to spend on this. I want to get flipping trains going. I'm going to need truck delivery routes here as well. Otherwise, these they will not kick off at all. These lines will not get things going. But we're going to go truck station. Anything that would cover this side of how bizarre. What's bizarre? I hear you cry. No, what's bizarre is that this has just spontaneously started building up with no real effort from me. Yeah, let's do that, and then let's make life good again and do a bit of this. Is that? Yeah, that's Large Street. That's fine. Do a bit of this. There we go. Yeah, now it's probably connected. Even better. Yeah, so I think the place for the drop-off here, drop-off truck station, and yes, I am aware that you can use passenger stops for delivering goods, but I don't agree with it in principle. All right, okay, so this is Dublin food. There we go, down to there. DUB food. Right, now, next, Edinburgh, same deal. Because the docks themselves are too far away from the centre of town, or from any part of town, really, to do the job. What have we got? Where is my... That's just a bus depot. Where's my trucks? That's a real shuttle job, that one. So I think we're going to need something vaguely useful. What have we got here? New carriage and a new, that's Norwegian by the looks of it. Tremendous. All right, medium street. Can we trot you down here without bulldozing anything? There we are. What sort of coverage will I get from that? Not great, if I'm honest. Barely any coverage at all. I mean, it'll do it, but you know, it's not gonna make for massive demand. We'll go with that and hope that the city develops according to the grand scheme. And that one, please. There you are. So this is EDI food. EDI food. You know what I should be doing? You know what I should be doing here? I should be buying the trucks and setting them in motion now. Otherwise, we're just going to have to do another tour of the facilities in a few minutes. That's a tram depot. That's no help to nobody. Where are we? There must be. I must have a regular road depot around here somewhere. What are you? You're another tram depot. No, that's no help. Have I deleted it? I mean, I can't rule it out. It's the kind of thing I do, but... Okay, right. Well, I'll just build a fresh one. The point of this was just going to be quick. This was going to be a quick setup to getting things going. And to be fair, this is going to start generating some demand, but only when those ships actually reach their destination for the first time. Right, Freightliner Cascadia, that'll do the job. Yeah, sure, right, we'll have two of these in Edinburgh, please. More than enough. The other thing that I'm going to need to do is to change up the fuel route, because at the moment those trucks will wait until full forever and a day. There we go. See? Look, he's just waiting. Route. Here we go. Full load. Just run. Right? Set it to run and then everything's good. Right, okay, so that's Edinburgh done. I should drop back and do Dublin, and then we will crack on and do Norway and France. Dublin Central. All right, see, you've got what we need. Give me another two of these. And, you know, there's a chance I'll need more later on, in which case I'll buy more later on. But right now, all I'm doing is I just want to buy enough to get demand operational. And again, you're waiting until you're full, aren't you? There you go. Just go. Previously, I've used wait until full in those situations in order to make sure that I haven't got, you know, trucks just running up expense and accomplishing nothing in the process. Now, let's have a look at this. What have we got here? You've got a little bit of commercial coverage, but realistically, what I want is to hit this section here. Now, all this track needs redeveloping, but if I were to make a dedicated... No? Collision. Yeah, you can't do it over points. All right, in which case... What do we want here? What I'd quite like is to just, you know, plumb something in there. How do you feel about that? That's a lot of buildings to bulldoze for a fairly minor plan. No, don't like any of that. I want to service this big fella here. Have I got a truck stop in there already? Because this has developed quite nice. Oh, hold on. What are you picking up? No, you're not even close to the mark. I want a nice quick route that gets me deliveries into the CBD. And I think it's going to be easiest to do something like that. Which building are you trying to remove there? Let's do that. Which is, you know, kind of weird looking. And then we'll have a drop off of the goods variety over here. One building will be removed, but that is servicing quite a lot of blue, which is what we want. There we go. Right, so that's a nice quick route. So we only need to put, well, really, we only need to put one truck on here to make that work. New line, this one, that one. Thank you. And this is TOU fuel. Fuel, food. TOU food. There we go. Right, and then we'll stick a truck on that. What are you? Right. Stick another freight liner on that one. Set line to lose food, please. Now, I need to go through all of the vehicles that I have previously bought and modernize at some point. It's been a very long time since I've done modernization. So I'm, you know, probably running quite a lot of, you know, horse-drawn carriages, which, okay, that's a bit of an exaggeration, but, you know, not by a million miles. I think that one's covering enough, you know. I do think that is covering enough of that to pay off, which is good, because it means that the existing fuel delivery route that I'm running will service everything nicely. There we are. There's one. All right, so TRM fuel, we'll change that to TRM goods. We'll set the vehicle replacement freight liner. There you go. 25%. How many vehicles are running on there? Two. Well, okay. Right, we'll just leave that running, and then as soon as those are replaced, we'll get rid of them. So theoretically, we have now created a little bit of demand for food here at Port Nelson, which is, you know, just as well. Hold on, I need to pause for a moment. And the reason I need to, in fact, I'm gonna need to pause in a minute. Go on, you, I want you in and out, please. We need to update this station. I know, when I set this up, I didn't think I'd need to upgrade it ever, but it turns out I do. So, you know, there is that. What? How much are you carrying? 207. 207's pretty respect. Given the frequency of delivery, 207's not bad at all. You're all done. Good show. Right, and then as soon as that's clear, we'll pause. Right about there. Okay, good. Now, we need to upgrade this to have an additional line. It means we're going to sacrifice 70-odd oil, but, you know, we'll get over that. Apply. Yes? Yeah? Yes. There we go. Right, and then we need to adjust this line so that it comes in on that side, like this. No, we don't need any electrification, thank you. The reason for that is we're going to run a line out from, where am I going to run it from? I had a notion that this would, there we go, out from here, right, and then into there, like that. There you go, it's just going to work. First time, pop, bosh, job done. No, not so much. Not so much. Okay, right. Well, in which case, we'll just have to do it manually. Right, so first off, we'll get a corner around there. 40 is absolutely fine for that. All right, and then we'll run down here straight. Maybe even at a slight wonky angle. Get rid of this lot. And then we'll run that in here. Now, this is basically just going to be food deliveries out to the docks. There you go. So it's a bit of an S curve. So it's going to go out from there over to there. There you go. Pretty straightforward stuff. But what that will do is it will gradually start building up resources at the docks, ready to be transported internationally. Rock that across there. Not that anybody uses it. So we'll get that set up now. New line. And I guess this is a shuttle, really. So we're doing it. So it's going to be, you know, food port shuttle, something like that, over there. PRN foot bulk shuttle. No, just foot bulk. That'll be fine. And then for the next route that we're going to need, new line is this one here. And that's the line that is going to be bringing raw materials in the shape of grain and cattle to be processed. So this will be PRN food processing. Splendid. And then the next route that we need, because, you know, we're not doing anything by halves here. This is, we're going to get this going proper swiftly, is... right there. Give me a line that I can spot with ease, if you would be so kind. Port Nelson branch. No, not branch. Remove branch. Yep, that one. Sidings. There we go. You've chosen an odd route there. It's not the one I would have selected for you, if I'm honest. What have we got here? Yeah, I see what you're thinking. Is that the one that I want you on? Actually, that's probably all right. In fact, that's definitely all right. It's got a dedicated station. It's got a dedicated line coming up here, although that does render this end line here a little redundant. You know, a lot redundant. I'm okay with it. But what are we going to use this last one for? And then you've got a lot of wiggling going on here. And that's not using an upline either. That's using a no. We can't do that. That's not good enough. It kind of works because the oil dedicated liner will run in and out of there. That's, you know, that's not a problem. Having its own platform at Port Nelson. But it's not going to work in harmony with everything else that I'm chucking up there. So another bit of track is going to be required. So if we come down there onto and then single track here. All right, so if we do something like this. All right, and then on the way back, it's going to need to switch again. Oh, I hope I'm thinking this through correctly, because if I'm not, this is going to be a complete shambles. And I realize that there are several of you out there at present that are going like, complete shambles. You might want to look over your shoulder there, friend. You've been at complete shambles for a while. Right, where are you? This is sidings. If I add station that one there, what do you think then? Yeah, then you're on a shared station with that oil line, which is fine, but it isn't half going to hold things up. So what we actually want you to do is come in on the other platform there, unless I had another plan, but I don't think I did have another plan. I think that's the big boy's going through the main line, surely. Why would it not? Oh, hold on. No, that's fine. That's what it's supposed to do. That's what you intended for it to do. Good. Okay, that's fine then. All right, smashing. This is all deliberate and intentional. Good. All right. So what we need to do now is to set up a couple of signals here. We need one there. No. What are you doing? No. Look. No. You, everything was right. Don't try and interpret my purpose. There you go. That's what I want you to do. And then we're going to need another signal to benefit the other thing, that other thing that I'm talking about. This one here. There we are. Right. And those should be the only signals that those two lines need. Should be, but you know, we'll have to run it to find out for certain. Right. Anyway, this is going to be PRN food. On its own, and you know, admittedly, you know, naming three lines rather similarly is you know, likely to cause problems, but that should be fine. Right, another new line, because you know, why only have three new lines when you can have four? Right, from there, we're going to go all the way down to Chicago, right about here, in fact, Chicago distribution. Which means that for the first time, we're actually going to need to stick some signals on there. Right, let's... So this is obviously, you know, this is the end delivery point of goods when they've been processed. Now, in order to make this work, what we're going to want to do is we're going to set them up end first, right? So we're going to make final deliveries first, and then... Come on, give me some zoom in here. Game having a little bit of a ponder as to what I'm playing at. Actually, you've got an excess of signals there, chum. Let's get rid of them. Not that it really matters, but it looks to me like you've got enough signaling up here now. Maybe a little more up here. Now, what I still haven't done yet is I haven't created the routing from the depot out to the main line, or have I? No, I haven't, and that's so basically the route whereby trains can get back to where they're supposed to be. I also probably ought to route that over onto there. In fact, that would do the trick. It's going to look a little bit funky, but and it's just another bit of track that you're not going to want to block. It's not clever. This is not clever track laying. But, you know, that'll do the job, probably. I'm probably going to redev this section as well and make it a little bit better, but I'm going to wait until I've got, you know, anything working before we do that. Now, these two platforms here that trains do go through, they don't actually, they won't have anything stopping on them. So effectively, this is just regular track. So we can put up points on here, and we're not going to be blocking anything we shouldn't be, theoretically. You're going this way, so I could put a signal on there, but then you are creating mayhem on that one. So we don't want to do on that one, but we could put one on there just before these points. And potentially aid the queuing. So if we do another one there as well, and then we'll stick another set. If assuming we've got room, it really depends how long the train is. If I stick one there, we're blocking all manner of points, so I don't want to do that. Let's give it plenty of space. We'll stick one there, and then we'll stick another pair on here. Okay, right. I think we'll see. I don't doubt that we will need more signal set up in that in the future, but Chicago food. Right, so that's four lines there. Now, before I go any further, given that, like I said moments ago, we're going to be working end back. So we do the distribution of food first, which means I need some kind of truck stop up here. And I mean, it's already suggesting exactly the kind of area that I want to stick this in. Yeah, somewhere, maybe here, maybe up there somewhere. Let's have a quick evaluation. Come on, what have you got for me? Yes. No, I'm not really feeling any of it at the moment. That's that. What about on this corner? How much are you lighting up? Not a vast amount. Nope, that's a bit better. What if we just come around the corner? There you go. That's the one right there. Okay, fine. All right, new line from this one. Chicago South. Goodness me. This is God. Anyway, that's a long way to Chicago distribution. Which route have you chosen to go there? Through the absolute worst traffic known to mankind. Okay, well, it'll work, but I might need to brute force the number of trucks on there. So this is Chicago food. Now, I have called two the same there. I'm certain I'm not going to get those confused. So we start out by sticking some trucks in Chicago to actually deliver the stuff. And I will have a depot somewhere. I will certainly have a truck depot. I mean, Chicago's got all manner of stuff going. It's just where stuff is. Let's just build another one. Right. No, I don't want that because by sticking it there, I'm potentially blocking future growth opportunities. So we'll stick it out over here. Right, there we are. Buy me some road vehicles, the freight, and so we've got a choice here. I mean, we could go with, I like the Peterbilt personally. I mean, I think the Freightliner may be American as well, and I've been using it as European all this time because this 40-ton truck is definitely one of the European ones. But I like the Peterbilt. Peterbilt's a good, classic American style truck. So let's go with three of those, which is aggressive. Chicago food. Get to work. Right, okay, that should do the trick. Now I can start thinking about trains. So that one's done. So we're going to do the food train next. Let's unpause the game. Get that rolling. Now, this is going to cause all manner of mayhem. I'm certain of it. But it has to be done if we're going to progress. So what should we run on this one? It's tempting to stick another big boy on there, but I think I'll stick with just one of those as a legacy setup. Now, actually, what's the big boy capable of in terms of top speed? 81. And then 4, 5, and 600. 65. And this SD40 is just not, you know, they're just not up to it. That's a little bit more like it. You know what? I'm going to, yeah, let's double hit it. Right. 1, 2. It's a little bit slower than the big boy, but it should be pretty funky. Right, that's the general plan there. Right, multiple unit. No, not multiple. Wagons. Give me wagons. And then food delivery, which I believe is in boxcars. What do you got? 18 in those. I think that'll probably do the trick. Made with aluminum. Okay, right. Well, I want to ship loads down there. So give me capacity of 340. Yeah, that'll do it. Now, this is not going to pay off for years. You're going on Chicago food. There you go. It's going to be a while before this gets up to speed in terms of demand. We've got to watch it come out, really, haven't we? Haven't we? See, look at that. Marvelous. I did say this area was going to get pretty busy. Actually, no, pause. I've got an even better idea. Right, now, out of this next one, let's buy another train. Now, this one is going to be our food processing train. So let's... what do we want for this? I think we might stick with the EMDs, you know. They're only little. They don't carry much, but this will do the job. And then on the wagon side of things, we're going to be carrying, what are we carrying? Livestock and grain. Now, people have previously said you should only really try and pick up one or the other rather than both. All right, in which case I'm going to do grain. All right. Someone's going to tell me that that's a terrible idea at some point, but that's what we're going to do. Right, where are we? This open wagon, 13. No, gondola, 18. Yes, we seem to have. We've got quite a lot of choice. That's very German. All right, okay. So it's going to be this big gondola, isn't it? I reckon. Okay. Can do 99 miles per hour. Well, that's more than it needs to do. Right, we'll have this shipping 216 to start with. I'll upgrade that as the need arises. Right, your PRN food processing. PRN food processing. There we go. Good. Yes, that's PRN food processing. If I get this wrong, which, you know, obviously we can't rule that out, what will happen here is I'll create a logjam that I will not be able to resolve unless I actually start sending stuff back to the depot. So, you know, we've got that to look forward to. Right, next up, buy trains. I want another one here. This one, locomotive. I'm going to have one SD40 on this. Like that. All right, and you are food. Just food all the time. It says boxcars. Should we use a different one? You know, for a bit of, just for variety. All right, okay. Well, what do we want? Let's go 8 of them. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 104. Plenty. Set line, and you are going to be PRN food. That one. Okay, and then last one, PRN food bulk. Is that's the one that takes it to the harbour, right? Central. Yes. Can't help but think I should have put this one on earlier. Ho-hum. Well, you know, that if there's no room for disaster, there's no room for fun. Locomotives. Right, just, you know, for the sake of variety, we'll stick this General Electric on there. The Dash 8. Prince amongst trains. And then This one, we're going to want this one to haul a fair shake as well. So we'll have this doing 270 set line PRN food bulk. All right, okay, so right, that's all of our runners and riders set up there. We now are going to let the chips fall where they may. All right, I've gone just beyond standard tempo, just for, you know, just to keep things rolling along at a decent lick. This will be the Chicago train, right? Right, let's make this a funky colour. Change my play on that. What do I feel about excessive blue? Excessive blue's all right. I'm not 100% certain. What have we got? Another bus. How terrific. Now, all of this is going to be fine, providing this train goes on the right path, which it looks like it's done first time. I don't like excessive blue. Yeah, dirty orange, no. Let's go with... You can't go wrong with green, so I've gone with green. Okay, right, this metro line is getting in the way all the time. Right, what's coming out next? Oh, look at this. Oh, look, that's a hedonistic train shot. Right, you, food processing. Right, so I guess we've opted into grain as our food source of choice. That's repellent. That's a little better, I guess. Tell you what, instead of mucking around, let's slow things down and you know, just get a completely gnarly shot out of this. This is, of course, you know, exactly what we hope to accomplish in setting up this distribution hub, is you know, a stack load of engine-based train. Look at these two drag racing down here. Madness. Where are you going? Where are you going? Oh, I see. No, okay, that's a plan. That's a good plan. And you're going up there. Well, you never know. Well, look, it's working. Look, see? I mean, we've got this stuff. Actually, those two are on the correct lines. That's phenomenal. I hadn't expected it to work immediately. I expected a small amount of fiddling around from yours truly to get this to work, but no, we're there, look. There we go. Just, you know, all the trains. This is as, you know, this is busy can be. Now, okay, I've cheated by setting them all in motion at once out of the depot, but, you know, there's got to be some style points going on here, haven't there? They have. I make the rules. Okay, this is pretty cool. Now, I mean, the thing is, I do need to take it a little easy, just temporarily, because otherwise, I'll end up with running costs I can ill afford. But you know, getting this stuff going is going to be quite good fun. There we go. Right. Okay. So we've got productions happening here. It's up to 40 production already. That's good. It's going to need to be a lot more than that, but I'm going to have to demonstrate demand for that to happen. And I mean, the one thing we won't get is demand at the port until all of those ships have actually done something. In fact, here they come now. So there's Dublin and there's Edinburgh coming in. The other two ships, I imagine, have gone to the other end of their route first. But, you know, it all counts. Right, there's only one runner and rider left to go, and that is this one, which also appears to be on the correct line. There we are. Terrific. Okay, right, now that's going to take some time to bed in. So why don't you go off and do something else for a bit, and then I'll return in the fullness of time, and we'll see how we're getting on. Thank you very much for watching today. I've been Colonel Failure. What are we going to do next? Next time we're going to expand to Atlanta and possibly beyond, out to Miami, because that will kick all of this stuff up another gear, if such a thing were possible. And so you're not going to want to miss out on that. Chuck us a like if you would be so kind. That would be greatly appreciated. And I'll be back very soon with a little bit more. So subscribe to ensure you don't miss it. Thank you very much for watching. Good time on Hooter. Cheerio!